I would never say that there's no systemic racism, and for that I apologize.
RCMP Commissioner Brenda Luckey trying to set the record straight after flip-flopping on whether or not the force suffers from systemic racism. She was testifying at an emergency meeting of the House of Commons dealing with the problems facing the force. After admitting that the force does indeed suffer from systemic racism, she struggled to give a specific example.
Yes, there's absolutely systemic racism. For example, we have a physical abilities requirement evaluation. It's an obstacle course. In there, there's a 6-foot mat that you have to do a broad jump. And when we put the lens on it and reviewed that physical requirements test, evidence told us that the average person can broad jump their height. So, of course, how many 6-foot people do we hire? And there are people in all different cultures that may not be 6 feet.
You can't tackle the problem if you can't understand the problem.
Luckey has come under fire after saying she struggled with the definition of systemic racism and she didn't believe it was a problem in the force. The deaths of two Indigenous people in New Brunswick recently ramped up pressure on the commissioner to acknowledge the problem. That, coupled with several videos of Indigenous people being brutalized by RCMP, has Luckey scrambling to address the issue. Khan suggests finding a new commissioner for the force.
When you have the top officer, the leader of the RCMP, trying to explain systemic racism within the police force as being, you know, an issue of a problem with this sort of test, it clearly says she doesn't understand what that reality is.
Luckey says Mounties are responding to more mental health calls than ever before and says now is not the time to defund the police. A call by activists to take money away from their budgets to fund social service programs.
At 3 o'clock in the morning, when somebody's wielding a knife and they're suffering from a mental health crisis, that is not the time to bring in mental health practitioners. It's time for the RCMP to go in. In many communities, there is no addictions counseling. There is no mental health crisis centers. So in those times of crisis, we are the first response.
Canada's public safety minister supporting the call for change. Bill Blair says he's contacting Indigenous leaders to find out how to best transform policing in their communities and to make First Nations policing an essential service.
That the First Nations policing program has been a program for more than 3 decades in this country. It needs to become an essential service.
In Ottawa, Nigel Newlove, City News.